Good day, subscribers. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am Jeremy. This is the Financial Education Channel, and today I'm sharing with you 46 stocks I track. Now, that sounds like a ridiculous amount, right? 46 stocks I track. It doesn't seem as exhausting as it may seem when you hear that number, 46 stocks. The majority of these stocks I look at, which, by the way, I use a stock tracker app, so I know I'll get a million questions. What app are you using there? It's called Stock Tracker, okay? The majority of them I'm tracking, some of them I actually own, and some of them I may potentially own over the next few weeks or a few months. I'm just keeping an eye on them. And a few others I just track for, reasons of maybe it's a big interest stock that a lot of people are very interested in, so I track it for that reason. So those are kind of the three different reasons, but the majority of the time I'm looking at this list, I'm just trying to see stocks that are going up or down more than 4%. If I see something like that, then I'll actually click on the stock, I'll actually look at what news came out. Why is this stock making such a big move today? But if the stocks, particular stock didn't make a big move that day, I won't even look at it in depth unless it's a stock I actually own or what I'm planning on buying very, very, very soon, guys. So it's not as exhausting as it may seem, but these are the 46 stocks I track. I hope you guys enjoy this and maybe you'll find some good stocks for yourself in here. So in the list, I always order, the most important to the least important whenever I do my stock tracker list, right? So GoPro is the number one. Obviously, if you've ever watched any video pretty much in the history of the channel, you understand I'm a big GoPro shareholder. You know what they do. They're a camera company, drone company, software company. Wynn Resorts, my second biggest position. That's the second stock listed there. They own gaming resorts in Macau and here in Las Vegas. Cruise is Cirrus Logic. This was the number three stock on the September edition of four stocks I'm buying. And they have to do with Apple. They're a semiconductor company that makes audio chips for Apple iPhones and iPads and things like that. Next stock down, that was a four stock that was listed on the September edition of four stocks I'm buying. That's called L Brands, ticker symbol LB. They own Victoria's Secret, Bath and Body Works, great company, low valuation. Google, this was one that used to be on four stocks I'm buying, just got kicked off recently, and if you don't know what Google is, and I can't help you, you're probably on the wrong channel. Michael Kors, is the next one there. They are a handbag maker, they also make wallets and some other things like that. Kind of a luxury, accessible luxury play there. They were on it for a while, but they were on it only for a month, but the problem was that stock went up so big, so fast, I actually sold my position in that, but I'm still tracking it. Snapchat, next one down there, I track that one pretty closely because my wife owns some shares in it. Only about 2% of her portfolio is probably in that one, but I do track Snapchat, and also it's a very widely, it's a stock that has a lot of interest out there, so I definitely track that one. NVIDIA, I track that one, not because I'm so much interested in investing myself because it has a pretty high valuation on it currently, but mainly because it's one of those stocks that is so popular, I just have to track it. Starbucks, a company I used to be invested in, sold out, maybe 2 or 3 months ago. One I may be buying back. I'm just tracking it right now, keeping a close eye on it. Groupon, next one down there. It was one I was thinking about buying a while back, and I missed my opportunity when it was in the $2 range. Now it's over $4. I don't know. I may actually delete that one from the list sometime soon. That's a deal-related company. Qualcomm, next one down there. Qualcomm, one of the biggest semiconductor type companies out there. They make tons of different chips for things. They're in big lawsuits right now with Apple and Samsung. Their stock is down a ton over the past year, year and a half. That's why I'm tracking that one. Maybe it gets to a valuation that, I just have to dip my toes in. Shopify, they're one of the hottest stocks in the entire stock market. I keep track of that one just because it's literally one of the hottest stocks out there. Company I actually believe in a lot for the long term, but man, their valuation is so ridiculous right now. MU, a super low valuation memory play there. I track that one just kind of see what's going on there. Maybe if it got back down to the $28 or lower range, I may dip my toes in MU there. Amba, Ambarella. This one I used to track super heavy because all GoPro cameras, and GoPro is my number one investment. GoPro cameras use Ambarella chips in them, but now GoPro's shifting their production to Qualcomm. They're going to start using Qualcomm chips more than likely in all the new cameras. So Ambarella won't be as important for me to track. I may actually invest in that company, but it would have to be lower than it is currently because they're not in the new DJI Spark drone. They just lost their biggest customer, which was GoPro, so we'd have to go down quite a bit more for me to actually start investing in Ambarella. UAA, Under Armour, Nike's biggest competitor out there, a stock that's just been hammered, but still too high of a valuation for me to dip my toes in. RH, one of the hottest stocks in the stock market this year, guys. This stock has just done amazing. Used to be on three stocks I'm buying, you know, several months ago. I probably hasn't been on a list for 9 months or so, but I definitely tracked that one. Facebook, I mean, is self-explanatory there why I would track that one. Amazon, same deal, such a big company, I gotta track it. Cabela's, one of my former biggest investments ever, most successful investments ever. I still keep track of it, just like, you know, you keep an eye on your ex, you know, on Facebook or whatever. Next one down there, Fitbit, that's a valuation type play there. You know, I would have to see something from their Ioniq smartwatch as far as sales go before I would, you know, strong sales before I would really dip my toes in that one. AMD, next one down here, not a company I'm really interested in investing in, but I keep track of it because it's another stock that is widely held among the public, and being someone that's on the internet talking about stocks, it's definitely a stock I need to track. Apple, obviously the biggest company in the world, you gotta track Apple. I don't care if you're invested in it, not invested in it, you gotta track Apple. And also, one of my investments, Cirrus Logic, very heavily tied to Apple. Apple, you just gotta track that company. Disney, next one down here. This one I may invest in at some point in time. I just want a little lower than it is currently. One of the best run companies in the world, but you know, struggling on the ESPN side and some of the content plays with, you know, people cable cutting and all that. Textron, they make helicopters and all types of fun stuff. Just a fun stock I track. Pandora, a company I used to be invested in. Pandora, I don't even know why I have it on the list. I probably would never even invest in it, even if it went down to, I don't know, $6 or something like that. I should probably delete that one. eBay, definitely a company I'm very interested in investing in. Something I track heavily. I don't know why I haven't invested in it yet. I really don't. Maybe I just want a little lower, but definitely a company I track. One of the biggest e-commerce plays out there, especially in North America. Alibaba, the biggest e-commerce play as far as China goes, definitely a company I track. Man, I should have gotten this one a long time ago, guys. I really wanted to, and I just didn't pull the trigger, and you know, it's just gone up and gone up. Zillow, the biggest play as far as real estate goes. If you're talking about real estate in the web, they own the Zillow app and Trulia app. If you've ever looked for a home, you've probably looked for it on one of those two apps before. They also own, I believe it's realestate.com. Race is Ferrari, a fun stock to track there. Probably way overvalued at 109, but you know, you never know there. Skyworks Solutions, one of the biggest semiconductor companies out there, has grown like crazy over the last 5 to 10 years. The stock I always track for valuation reasons, if it gets below 90, you know, it's definitely a stock I'm interested in. Elf is a beauty company. They're big distribution with Target. I'm not too interested in a lot of the beauty plays right now. Taco is Del Taco. Definitely a stock, you know, that's way under the radar that probably most people have never even heard of. That's a public company. Definitely a stock I may invest in. The same thing with Loco there. I think their plays on kind of the, you know, Chipotle struggles. I think they're good plays because they're cheaper alternatives that also have some pretty good quality. So something I may dip my toes in one of those two. Eventually, that's why I track them both together. They're Taco and Loco. Very similar plays, actually. Noodles and Company, a crap company, a crap restaurant stock that I just keep track of to see maybe if they can turn it around. Maybe I can ride the wave there, but I haven't seen anything yet from them. Square, oh, I'm so frustrated that one. One of the worst ones as far as a stock I was really, really close to investing in. I was actually going to buy call options in that expired in 2018, and I could have made so much money on that. Square is a company I use for my business. Basically, you can do transactions right through your iPad or phone or whatever, things like that, guys. If you go to Starbucks or a lot of restaurants, actually use Square as their readers and whatnot that they swipe cards through, and they make money every time those cards are swiped. So, missed opportunity there, but I still track the stock. Nant Health, a little spec play there that I just like to keep track of just to see what happens there. Twitter, you know, Twitter is one of those companies I don't think they'll ever have major growth. It's just a question of will they be able to get back to profitability in a major way. If they can, maybe it's a stock I'm interested in. For now, I just track it. Activision Blizzard, the stock has moved up so much since they acquired my company, King Digital. You know, definitely one I track, a great company long term, a little overvalued for me personally right now, so that's why I don't own that one, but I do definitely watch it. Freshpet, a phenomenal company as far as, you know, the higher end of dog foods and cat foods and some of those kinds of things. iRobot, a stock I used to own and just has exploded after I sold it at, I don't know, $40 a share, and now it's at $95. Like, Jeremy sold, shoot off the gun, let's have this one rock it up there. They make the Roomba vacuum cleaner and a lot of different robot type cleaning products and stuff like that. Shake Shack, a burger company, higher end burger company. This one IPO'd, I don't know, maybe a year or two ago. One I track, interested in. Caterpillar, the biggest play as far as industrial equipment goes. Goldman Sachs there, the best run investment bank in my opinion in the world. I definitely track that one. It's actually the only bank-related company I do track. CMG, this one I believe was below $300 at one point on Friday. At some point I may dip my toes in Chipotle. I want it lower though. I'm greedy. I like it lower. Tesla, I believe so much in Tesla. They're the car maker of the future. They're going to have ridiculous amounts of market share in North America, probably in Europe as well. Definitely the car maker of the future. I have to track that one. Netflix, a phenomenal run company. You guys probably have Netflix, so I don't even need to explain that one. And it's just a widely held stock, so I keep track of that one. So those are the 46 stocks I track literally on a daily basis as far as their prices moving up and down. Like I said, anything over a 4% move up or down, I'll actually click on them, research more. Why is this one making such a big move? RH made a big move the other day. It was like up 40% or whatever, so I actually looked into that one. I believe it was, what stock was it? There was another, CMG, they made a huge move, so I looked into that. I think it was Friday, and I saw that an analyst actually came out and downgraded them. That was why their stock went down. So I like to just look into it if there's a big move one way or another. So do you guys own any of those stocks? Let me know in that comment section if you own any of those. Let me know how many stocks you track on a daily basis. I would love to know from you guys. Do you track 5, 10, 100, a million? I would just love to know from you guys. I hope you enjoyed this. If you just came across this channel, you may want to subscribe. We talk personal finance in the channel. We talk entrepreneurship. I'm an actual business owner. I give away so many business tips. We talk stock market investing more than anything. Thank you for watching, guys, and have a great day.